Hey guys, my name is Hogan, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to connect your GoDaddy domain name with your Hostgator account. So basically, if you recently got your domain from GoDaddy, but you didn't get hosting there, and you've got hosting somewhere else, for example, you got it at Hostgator, then I'm going to show you how to connect the two together so you can start creating your WordPress website as quick as possible, right? So we're going to jump right into the tutorial. And essentially what we want to do is we want to log into our GoDaddy account. And we also want to log into our Hostgator account. So you can click on customer login and then click on portal login. So you can also log in from the cPanel directly with the details they actually sent you through your email. But I'm going to be showing you this way as well. So we're going to log in here. And what we want to do here with GoDaddy is we want to scroll down, right, to see all our domain names. So I've got quite a few domain names, so you guys probably don't have as many. So we're gonna select this one here, okay? So this one's the webdemo123.site. And then here we need to hover over DNS and then we need to click it, okay? So now what we need to do is we need to go over to Hostgator and we wanna go to our cPanel. So we can click on hosting here. And then what we can do is click on cPanel. All right, so this is gonna take our take us to the cPanel where we're gonna copy the name server. So copy the primary name server on the right, copy that to your clipboard, come to your domain manager here, so DNS management. Sometimes the UI might change, the user interface. So what you need to do is to navigate to the name server section, right? So we can click on change here. And then what we need to do is just to click on, I'll enter my own, paste it over here, and then come back over here and paste in the secondary one, right? And then paste it again. And then click on save, right? So once that is saved, then what we need to do is we need to go back to our cPanel to install WordPress. So what we need to do first is we need to add on the domain, all right? So scroll down to domains and you can click on add on domains. And then what we need to do is add in the domain name. So in this case, it is the webdemo123. I'm just gonna copy it from here. Okay, or you can just type it in just like that, okay, without the HTTPS. And then just click on the outside here, right? And then you can click on add on domain. All right, so that has been added. Now we can install WordPress. So we can click back here to the cPanel area, all right? And then we can click on WordPress installer. So if you don't see that, because sometimes they do change it, try to look for the WordPress installer. For in this case, it's up here, so just click into it. And then what we need to do is we need to select the domain for installation. So here we're going to select the domain, which is this one over here. For the directory, leave it empty, click on next. So here I'm just going to type in blog title as test. You can change it later. So for the username, I'm just going to put in my username, first name, last name, and then also make sure you put in your correct email address, okay? Because they'll also send you the details there. And if you forgot your details, for example, your password, they'll send it here. So click over here and then click on install, and that's going to install onto the new domain, right? And then I'll show you how to log in. All right. So sometimes that does take maybe 15, 20 minutes for that to actually set up on the back end, right? So sometimes you need to wait. So what I'm going to do is just copy over the password to my clipboard first, and then I'm going to click on login. Okay, so as you can see, it's not up yet. So I'm gonna take a break and then come back and show you how to log in. Okay, so after 20 minutes, now it's finally ready. So I'm going to put in my username and also the password that you copied before. So they should also send you a email, right, to your email that you set in before with the password in case you forget. So I'm going to click on this one. Okay, so this is your dashboard, your WordPress dashboard, and this is only what you can see, right? So what your customers see or your visitors see, then this is the home page, right? So I'm going to show you just to configure some basic settings to get you sort of up and running first before you follow any sort of tutorial, because I think it's really, really important. So the most important thing is to ensure that your website is secure. So as you can see on the top left here, it says not secure. And this is not good because when someone comes to your website and says that, then they don't trust it, right? So to fix that, what we need to do is we need to go to your Hostgator control panel area. Okay, so you can type in SSL here and you can click on SSL certificates, right? So this is basically just going to navigate you to the sort of the dashboard area for Hostgator so that you can check if the SSL has been installed on your domain. So this is the new domain that I just added in. Okay, so if it says pending, then it should be good to go, right? If it's not, it says like attention or something, error or anything like that, then what you need to do is contact the support here, the live chat, and tell them that you recently added a new domain and you would like them to activate the Let's Encrypt SSL onto that specific domain. Okay, that's gonna take about 5-10 minutes to get that done. Now, once when that is done and that is active, then what you need to do is go back to your website over here. All right, and then we can go to plugins over here. And here they actually have a lot of pre-installed things with Hostgator. I don't really like it. So I just want to sort of deactivate all of them for now, right? Because there's just so much clutter everywhere. You can reactivate it later when you need it. All right, so what we're gonna do is click on add new and we're gonna search for a plugin. So this one's gonna be called really simple SSL. Yep. And then what we're going to do is we're going to install it. So this one with 4 million active installs, click on install and then we're going to activate. Okay, so make sure that it does say that it is pending over here, right? And then it should have this message over here, right? So make sure you know your password. You can actually, let's go over the users and you can change your password. So over here, right, we can click on edit for your profile name. And here we can scroll down to the bottom and here generate password. And then you can generate just a new password, okay? And then you can update your profile first, right? Because like the Hostgator, they gave you one which was like super duper long, so that's not good. Here you can go ahead and activate SSL. And then that might probably log you out, okay? So let's say if you want to log back into your WordPress dashboard, then it's really important that you know this. So I'm just going to delete the URL. Okay, so let's go to our homepage, right? So this is the homepage, and to log in, right? Type in /wp-admin and click on enter. Okay, so here we're going to log in. So as you can see, you should see the lock icon or the padlock here, and that means your website is ready to go. So the other thing that you wanna do is you wanna make sure you go to your settings and permalinks, and then you wanna change your post name to this one over here, right? So it basically includes the page title within the URL, okay? So normally it doesn't include that and it's not good, right? So it's not good for search engines. Right, so I think that is pretty much it for this video. Now you can essentially start, you know, following my tutorial, or maybe you can follow other people's tutorial, it doesn't really matter. I'll leave the links to my tutorials in the description below, and I'm gonna be creating the blog tutorial soon and also a new website tutorial as well as e-commerce tutorials and things like that. So that is pretty much it for this video, and see you guys in the next video.